the globalization, English has played an indispensable role in our life, which is being universally used. It is not only a tool of communication, but also the bridge connecting people around the world.
In terms of zodiac signs, there are lots of similarities between Western and Chinese ones. But compared with the Chinese zodiac, Western zodiac signs are much more commonly known to the world.
That's why we choose the familiar story of Chinese zodiac, along with English proverbs, to make people know more about the Chinese zodiac sign by way of learning English proverbs concerning the animals of Chinese zodiac.
Great! Therefore, we choose a special way to make children read creatively and interactively. So, let's check out some words. Let's go!
Chinese zodiac with English proverbs.
The first part of our book is the introduction of characters, including English proverbs about animals. For example, take the bull by the horns, or until the cows come home. The second part is the content of the story. On the lower part of the pages, we leave some blanks to be filled in about the English proverbs concerning the animal mentioned. For example, the mouse is selfish in the story. Hence, self is a bad counselor, related to the mouse.
Moreover, readers can consult the English proverbs to find the Chinese translation to avoid the time of translation. What's more, the English proverbs pamphlet is available anytime and any place. On the bus, in the bathroom, on bed. One of the features of our book is interaction, which makes the children not only self-oriented, but also self-motivated in learning English. Now, let's invite some children to experience the book with us.
Hi, what's your name?
My name is Erica.
My name is Emily.
你们知道有关于中国十二生肖的故事吗？
知道，
知道。
那你们知道有关于动物英文谚语吗？
不知道，
不知道。
那现在就让我们来示范如何使用我们设计与制作的十二生肖与英文谚语的小书来教小朋友动物英文的谚语。
然后在这边呢、我们因为这本书我们分成三个部分。第一个我们是角色介绍，翻开之后啊，每一个生肖啊，我们都有他们专属的谚语。然后像你是属
猪。
然后你看这边就是猪的谚语，那你是属
鸡，
这边就是鸡的谚语。然后之后这以后这一个我们是直接开始故事。玉皇大帝是不是举办了一个比赛，然后请动物都来参加，然后又选前十二名嘛。然后老鼠跟猫都有参加比赛，可是因为老鼠太自私了，所以他不想让猫赢得比赛，因为他想得到第一名，所以他就不告诉猫说要去比赛了，所以他就偷偷出门。然后我们看这些故事啊，我们翻到最后一个部分，那你觉得刚刚的故事符合哪一个谚语？
这个。
这个。好。那我们就贴过来。Self is a bad counselor.
自私非上策。
所以我们知道我们不可以像老鼠一样自私。
Whatever you do, do with all your might.
不管做什么事都要一心一意。
他讲到的啊，是不是符合这个？因为马他一心一意的想要完成比赛，他想要赢得比赛，所以他奋尽全力的往前跑，所以我们会知道我们做什么事都要像马一样。对，然后那再来这个是再念一次好了。
Whatever you do, do with all your might.
不管做什么事都要一心一意。
嗯，那这就是我们如何使用英文小书让小朋友学习动物的英文谚语。
Owing to the great number of 3C products and a huge amount of information on the internet, more and more parents are conscious of the critical role English is playing.
In this respect, we also turn our book into an e-book to jump on the bandwagon. Compared with the book, the e-book is more interactive and animated, though not touchable.
Now, we are going to introduce the features of our e-book. First, in order to catch children's attention, we started with sound effects. Second, with the changing of the story,
the characters will move actively in the e-book. For example, the mouse got first place because of its quick jump from the cow's back. This movement will attract children's attention, and they will look forward to watching the following part of the story.
Third, in the e-book, our English proverbs will show the Chinese translations, which would help the children understand the proverbs easily. English learning for them is no more a boring job but full of fun.
This is our introduction of e-book.
We choose the familiar story Chinese zodiac combined with many English proverbs.
This combination can make readers understand the morals of the story and the meanings of the proverbs more easily.
Children can learn English without pressure. What a great way to learn English! What are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?